maybe some board games in the future, but for now, I'm sticking to role-playing games. And I am back on this episode with part two. Possibly that's all the parts, not sure, we'll see how we go, of Ex Novo. Ex Novo is a city-building game. Let's just change the view. So Ex Novo is this beautiful book here, this beautiful cover here, from Shark Bomb Studios by Martin Nerurkar and Konstantinos Dimopoulos. Now, last week, I'll switch to the iPad view. No, that's me again. There it is. We were creating the Duchy of Duran. Here it is. And we got through the first few phases of creating our city. I have to remind myself quite what is going on. Let's have a look. I have too many screens happening here. Oops, I just drew. There we go. I'm using Procreate here for this. The Duchy of Duran. Ah, yes, we had our seat of government, these dark buildings over here. And we had a citizen. These blue circles are the citizen tokens here. And we had this river that led, so this, it's hard for me to, it's not quite possible for me to sort of highlight something without drawing it. So, but we have this river that led in from the, how the founders got to the city into this lake here. It's a slightly dirty lake. We've got this, if I remember more precisely, I was going for this kind of post-industrial, magic-ish, Victorian London-esque type place. A bit like, see if I can remember the TV show, a bit like, I have forgotten it already. I really like the TV show, but obviously has a very unmemorable name. Let me check again. Carnival Row, I've just remembered. Carnival Row, that was it. So this kind of like dark industrial book with bits of magic and fey creatures and things like that. The opposing factions, governments, if we like. And actually, we did give them names here. I gave them very original names. Yeah. Oops. I have a note. There we go. The Free League. We have the Despotus as one citizen, and the Free League are the opposing faction in our city at the moment. Get rid of this related note. It's slightly annoying. Excuse me. Oopsie daisy. It's probably not the best thing to start doing, is it? On a public stream. But anyway. I don't even know where this is. not really sure where it is. Oh well, we'll just have to put up with it for now. I don't think anything on those related notes is particularly personal, so hopefully it's getting in the way a bit more than anything. Oh well, okay. And yes, we had, this was the, these clouds up here. I think these were from the, let's remind ourselves here. It's a sunny, cloudy weather. I'm trying to remember quite what those bits were. I think is that we were saying it's a very distant place in a kind of barren landscape, and that is what they're looking at. The sun and the clouds the whole time because there's nothing else to see. I think that was my reasoning. we have this area is where the Free League hang out. These dark forests with these strange colored fruit, and there's dark creatures that lurk in the trees that no one is quite sure what they are. We have these magical. Oh yes, it was a relic of the creatures that came before when the Duchy of Duran was built. It was built on top of ancient relics, and these are signs of that ancient civilization or city or whatever it was. No one really knows before. And finally up here we have these tall reeds and grass that are in another section. So, it's myself remembering the story so far. Let's switch back and remind ourselves where we got to and where to next. Okay. So, yes, we got through our assumptions. That was not really necessary because it's just me. Our game expectations, just me. Our target size, we opted for, I think, 9 lines from memory. So yes, a small city. I'll make this a little bit larger, actually. That's a bit too large. Yes, a small city. We went for an age of... I think we went for development phases. I think I made a note of that in Evernote. Let me see. Grown, yes. So 10 development phases will happen. We added a variety of geography, which I think in our case was the... inland, yes, this one. Draw nothing. I drew some clouds instead. We had our lake. We had the wetlands. We had the woods. And we had the river. It was the ruins of a former settlement, as we just covered. A ruler's whim, that was the dark building. The hierarchy is an unstructured, it's an improvisational hierarchy. It doesn't entirely match the ruler, but anyway. Maybe the ruler is dying or died, I think. The factions, we had Seeds of Descent. 2 factions, 1 in control, the other newly born. That was it. And I think that's where we got to. So, let's see what is next and continue. And our factions, we named the city, Duchy of Duran. Development phases. So, let's zoom in a little here. I'll get rid of this sidebar so you can see, hopefully, nice and clearly. Let's make that fill the screen. Put it into the 2-page layout. I'm not sure if that's better or not. We'll see how we go. So, development phase. Now, I think we do this multiple times? Yes, multiple times. So we're going to do this 10 times for our city. I'm starting to wonder if that might be a little long and tedious, just hearing me doing it 10 times. Maybe we'll do it 5 and we'll see how we go. Maybe we're not quite as large as the city initially is. Yeah. Let's see how we go. So, historic events, random events, try to make sense of it within the story of the settlement. The question with each entry are inspirational prompts. Ah, you know what I'm missing? Dice. 1 second. I forgot that this game actually used dice. Just D6 from memory. So let's get some dice. Proper dice. Lovely. Here we go, the sound of dice. Okay. Often the results of the table ask you to put something on the map. Once you've done, you may want to write down the name of the event to provide a record. Roll on the event table, follow the actions, note down the event. And then if you want to, you can use a citizen token from the pool to add a district to the map. Is this in addition to the historic event? Or is it part of it. Is there any more details on that? During each phase. Okay, so we do it after each one. Okay, all right. Let's find our first historical event. I will switch to me. No, there I am. I am using OBS, Open Broadcast Studio, as many streamers do. And one problem I have found recently is that the scenes that you can create for setting these pre-configured views get muddled up a lot. And between some of the streams I do, everything's got rather jumbled. So the things I'm clicking on do not match what they actually are anymore. So do forgive my slight confusions here. I'll tidy those up in the next week. Anyway, let's have a look. I will flip, there it is, to our events. Here we go, three dice. I guess I'll put them in this order. Can you see that? Yes, one, two, two. So it looks like we have warfare. Skirmishes over resources. The control of a crucial resource leads to conflict and even to a few battles. What is contested and who wants it? I've got an idea here. So we've already discussed this. Now, I'll switch to the map. We've already discussed this giant lake here. And it's kind of very close to the two important factions in our world, in our city. So I think they probably fight over this. And we can see that there is actually a river point up here near the citizens, near the free citizens. So I reckon at a certain period, they maybe siphon off. Where I have to remember what brushes I have set here. Oops, set here. They siphon off some of the river, and I'm not in blue, that's for sure. They siphon off some of the river. Now this is not the right style, is it? What was I using before? Sketching. That's it, the appropriate pencil. They siphon off some of the river here and make their own smaller lake. And this means that parts of this lake get, oops, not quite that much, but shrink down. And we'll add some. Color in there. Back. It's actually making it dirtier, that's good. Maybe the Free League is less obsessed with trade and commerce and keeps their water in the intervening period after this a little cleaner. Let's make it slightly fresher looking. It's a bit green, but anyway. Okay, so that's what happens. The river, the lake gets split at a certain point. Okay, so what was the optional thing we could do? It was natural growth. If you want to, you can use a citizen token from the pool to add a district to the map. This means that during this period, the city grew normally from its usual mixture of a high birth rate and immigration. Add a district to the map. We've not done that yet, so maybe we should. I'm not really sure how to do that. Let's have a quick look through the rest of the manual and see if... Okay. Just to show you here. Districts. For districts, draw an irregular blob that demarcates the district's shape. It should be roughly the size of one region. set it out like, okay, all right, I think we should add a district. We don't really have one yet. So let's do that. Let's just keep us back up to here so I can remember where we are. Switch back. So let's have a look over here. There's a lot of empty spaces over the western side there. So I think let's maybe add a district over in this corner here. Could it be? I mean, we're going for this industrial Victorian type thing, so I think it'll be like a dark factory of some description. We'll add our citizen. No, not that pencil, obviously. I used too many pencils last time. I should remember which ones were which. I have absolutely no idea. Well, there we go. That looks reasonable. There's one citizen. So we need to remove one from here. So that's six we've used, I think. Okay. So let's think. What could it be like a factory industrial zone? Get more colours, eh? I want a nice kind of horrible dark looking grey. Oh, here we go. Yeah. Okay. So like a and then a big chimney with smoke and fire coming out of it. Some giant doors where people go in. A couple of windows. Another chimney here with smoke. And it's black and dirty. Dirty smoke here and some fire here. My drawing ability seems to have decreased in the past week, but anyway, whatever. yeah, that'll do. Okay, and what's the district called? I don't know. Something suitably kind of miserable sounding. let's call it I'm really running out of names here. I'm not being my most imaginative, which is perfect timing for a storytelling creative game. I've got a fan in front of me here, which I don't really need anymore. The temperature has dropped significantly, but actually the brand, if you can see that, is called Fitfort. I actually think that kind of suits like an industrial sounding area, maybe. So let's call it that. Fitfort District. There we go. All right, next. Okay, let's roll our dice. Okay, we have, can you see that? Yes, 2, 1, 3. So not warfare this time, thankfully. Politics. Ah, now this is perfect. The death of a beloved leader. This can be the one person in the hang on over here in the tower zone. here and a bureaucracy that dies and a faction loses or gains power. So, yeah, it's free league, we called them, yes, gain power because of this. So, I don't know, do we have to draw anything? I don't know how I can really draw this. I guess R.I.P. It's event 2, so we'll call it year 200. Our great leader is gone. So we get to erase. Oops, I seem to be erasing part of the building there. Hang on. There we go, better. And the Free League gain power. I guess that's good. Although, we all know what can happen. There we go. Okay, what's next? Let's see. Let's roll some dice. I don't think we'll have growth this time. The people are in mourning, and there's disillusion and conflict. Okay, we have 3, 5, 3. So, that is... Scroll down, need an app for this. scroll down. A resource loses value. How much are people's lives and livelihoods affected? Who loses the most? Who wins? Remove something. I don't have that many resources, really, apart from water. We have the factory. We have these trees. No, but no one is really destroying those resources. The reeds? Can you make things out of reeds? Is that a resource? Okay, let's switch to... Let's say the... We are in the plains in the middle of nowhere, so the riverbed. The riverbed dries up. That looks a bit healthy for water. That's better. It dries up. It should be kind of browner, really, I suppose. Dirty, muddy water. Quite sure how to get it bluey brown. I don't know. That'll do. Okay. So it dries up. There's not many rains for 1 year. So some of this valuable water in both of the factions dries up too. And there's less water. So people die through lack of water. People get disease through lack of clean water. I guess one of the citizens in this area here, we probably lose one because of that. Yeah, sad times. Okay, that was number 3. If it said 10, actually, this is reasonable. Let's keep going. Number 4. Okay. 4, 3, 1. Four, three, one. Scrolling down a little. Family structure changes. You know what? I think to prepare for this, we should have had a growth phase just before. Otherwise, there's not many people here right now, to be fair. let's do that. I've lost my place. There we are. Okay. And let's draw in a new district. So I suppose even though water is scarce, people still need it. So this district here seems reasonable of having good connection to both limited water supplies. So it'll kind of be like a sort of normal human settlement, maybe. And so we add a lot of small housing, varying sizes and varying quality, just lots and lots of it. It's a period of growth despite the lack of water. But it's poor, small, low quality housing that's quite dirty and quite filthy, and the poor water supply does not help. So we'll add in a new citizen here. So we're keeping stable population. Okay, now back to us, yes. Yes, I put the dice down in a slightly different way. 4, 3, 1. Family structure changes. The way people live together changes. Is for work, to save on rent. Do people enjoy this change? Increase or reduce the density of a district? I think having what we've just done makes perfect sense. Often when times are hard, people have more children because you need more people to survive. Maybe as the water situation is slowly improving at this particular time, the births are outweighing the deaths, so it grows. So let's switch. I guess I should save these values, really, shouldn't I? If I was an expert in Procreate, I would do things like this, but I am not. I'm learning too many things at once here. That's the problem. Okay. And more, 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 and more. So many new people moving in. But still into a very poor. So let's just recap here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4. So I think we need to update our tokens. So 7. Still quite a lot to go. Okay, great. Event number 5. Okay, 3, 1, 1. This is... up here somewhere, 3, here we go. Dependence on imports. This makes sense. We're running out of water. Self-sufficiency is a noble goal, but alas, the city would never survive without imported goods. What needs to be imported? Who provides it? Water. And here's the story. Here's what happens. So, a lot of people moved to this new faction. Actually, I think I was tracking the factions here. Yes, so a few things went a bit wrong there. So 2, and they currently have 0. So what happens here? The Free League has not really delivered what they promised. We had these water problems. They've had to import water from the far. And guess who they had to import water from? Dum, dum, dum. They had to import water from a long-lost relative of the original founder of the city, who comes back. Their name is Dragogis. That'll do, Dragogis. And they promise to bring in water from their faraway land where they have been living for the past few hundred years. It has plentiful water supply. Somehow through magic, and then, well, not through magic, oh, well, who knows, maybe it is magic. They flood water back into the rivers here. Fill that back up with some nice blue. Here. And of course over here too. Yep. It's looking like a child's sketch, isn't it? But because of that, we have a new citizen in town and a new representative of the old family coming back from beyond. Not something anyone ever expected to happen. So, back here. And when we go switch to our factions list, we now have people transitioning. So one citizen back with the Despotos faction. Yeah. They came back promising, they delivered. But who knows what will happen next. Let's increase a new district. I think we now have some prosperity. People are impressed by their new seemingly powerful benevolent leader. So they decide to build a new district up here, close to their area, but also to the water supply. And this is going to be like sort of nouveau riche, middle class families who take advantage of this new situation. So I reckon their buildings are made of gold. Or fake gold, probably. So they have these large kind of mansion type places. Yeah, something like this. They don't look that appealing, really, do they? They can have some turrets on top and some towers. And yeah, there's several of them here. This one has a giant tower with a lookout place that they can see over who might be looking at the water. Yeah, they have their own luxurious gardens out the back. So it's very kind of green at the back here. There we go. And we need to add a new citizen here. Go. So we have another one on the map. So 8 citizens. We're nearly halfway. Okay. All right. Event number 6. Five, four, four. Okay. What is that? Down, down, down. Civic infrastructure is neglected. Walls crumble. Roads fall into disrepair. Bridges collapse. Are the coffers empty? What has this new leader, charismatic leader from afar been doing? The work is incompetent, or is this malice and limited to specific districts? Well, you know what normally happens when a benevolent, seemingly benevolent, but maybe actually darker behind the scenes person sort of comes along. They pander to the people who support them. Over here, our new rich middle class. But, of course, a poorer area here are left to rot. Their places are left in poor maintenance and poor care and state of repair. I think I'm just gonna turn up my microphone a tiny bit. The level is looking slightly quiet there. I think that looks a bit better. There we go. They're in a poor state of repair. So, yeah, certain areas here get wiped out, crumbling away. We'll add some rubble here of where people once were. But there's still the same amount of people squashed into an even smaller space. Okay, let me just quickly check this volume again whilst we're here. I think that should be okay. Can you see? No, you can't. There we go. Good. I do have a micro in here that I don't want you to see. Excellent. Okay, number six. I don't think we'll have any new districts at this point. It seems like an inopportune time. Okay. 1, 2, 4. I think this is going to be war, which seems reasonable when these sorts of things happen. I do apologize for that loud noise outside. I'm not quite sure what's going on. Sounds like someone cleaning the streets. Criminal war band roam the area. The desperate or the greedy band together to raid the land. What unites them? Oh dear, I've spotted a little typo there, sorry. This seems great, this seems fantastic. So our desperate people here need food, they need water, they need materials. So firstly, they form raiding parties into the lake here and steal the water. Not all of it, just a lot of it. They also take some of these trees because they want to repair their housing. Who knows what they will unleash later? We shall find out. I think at this point, we should maybe add a new district. I think these people up here are still having a great old time. So we'll add another region of those, taking even more of the imported resources that the benevolent, maybe, dictator is bringing in. We'll add some down here. Let's say these are magical, shiny, purple buildings. Why not? Because why not? Indeed. And they're kind of like strange sort of tenty shaped buildings with gold leaf in them and sparkles. I don't really know why, but these look more like purple rocks, but anyway. Kind of busy talking and doing all sorts of things here, so yeah, we'll add some shiny spangly stuff to them. Kind of just like grey dirt, but anyways. It's like glitter and shine, obviously. And because they are strange people, they have their gardens, but their gardens are actually kind of aquamarine-y color. And we gain a new citizen again. Oops, so we need to update our count. Now, I think that was number 7. I got lost count ever so slightly there. Let's say. Okay. Next. Okay. 6, 3, 1. Let's see what that is. All the way down here. New discoveries. It's probably what's needed right now. Valiant explorers or a change in landscape reveals lost caves, hidden valleys, or a volcano. What values does this new place provide? What dangers does it bring? Ah, so what happened here is when the desperate people here were destroying the forest for building materials. They indeed unearthed a hidden cave, a hidden sort of grey, reddy looking stone, why not, cave. It was kind of like dirt. not quite what I was going for. That'll do. This cave here, and I kind of feel like we can bring in some texture here. Oops, no, not that large. So some texture into our cave here. And of course, every cave needs a dark, foreboding opening. So there it is, and there's a mysterious red light inside. So the resource is stone, but what dangers are there? We do not know. However, this newfound resource, stone, that they managed to build around, leads to a small building boom, and the industrial area flourishes, bringing new work, but obviously bringing other problems, which we may address later. So, let's say there's a lot of like small industry appears. And we have some more citizens to obviously keep that going. Okay, great. Two more. Ah. 6, 4, 5. So we're quite close to where we were before. Pests in the city multiply. An explosion of rats, pigeons, and cockroaches. What conditions led to this growth? How are buildings changed to adapt? Perfect situation here. These buildings were left to rot. It says remove something. I'm going to be slightly callous and remove a citizen. How are buildings changed to adapt? The people have to rebuild their buildings more cleanly with this newfound material. But this is good. This is good for them. They use a lot of this old rubble. Some of the old buildings from the area remain. But they also build some nicer, newer buildings as well. So we fill in some nice, slightly newer, cleaner buildings for the common folk, the common workers of the Duchy of Duran. And they even get some opportunity to bring a little greenery in for themselves too. And through this program of cleansiness, then the it gets more sanitary and the district improves. And you know what this means? We gain a nice, new, fresh citizen, a new generation of citizen to take the place of the ones who just fell in the disease from a few years earlier. So we have 11 now. We've used, I'm not entirely sure if that's how I'm supposed to be keeping track of things, but I'm continuing now. Okay. One more. Wow. We're really keeping with the sixes here. 663. Let's see what that means. 663. Interesting times. An especially turbulent stretch of history. Is it a curse or a blessing? Is there a cause for this? Roll for two events and combine them. Okay. I have 354, which I think we had before. 354, all the way up here. Oh no, a new industry takes root. Okay, good. Add a district or resource. And so a new industry. And 632. A new resource. So new factories, new resources. Which faction leads the exploitation? Well, I think we can hazard a guess, can't we? So there is boom, there's all these new workers now. So this means that new industry is built right near the homes, of course. Lots and lots of small factory. What on earth am I drawing there? Seems to be defying gravity. Lots and lots of small and medium-sized factories emerge. And they all bellow out smoke and dirt. Because they find a new resource. What is this new resource? No. What could it be? Let's think of something strange. It's a new resource that they find in this district next door called plutonium. And it's full of it. Fields and fields and fields of plutonium, this dark purple substance that when refined creates an energy source. And of course the despot decides to take as much as they can to fuel their efforts elsewhere in faraway places. And unfortunately the dust from burning this plutonium kind of settles. Let's see, it should change. Right, perfect. Ah, yes, look at that, perfect. Settles on all sorts of other regions, including the old industry, the new industry, the old mythological parts, and even down in the mystical areas of town. But it is thriving, but dirty and filthy. Okay, now we're reaching the final phase. Just with a little bit of time to spare. Let's see. Topping out phase. Topping out is what you do when you're done with the basic shell of a building. So now, So now after all the historic events are done, it's time to wrap up the settlement. During this phase, you get to spend all remaining citizen tokens and put your final touches on the settlement, remaining growth. In player order, you take turns using the remaining citizen tokens for districts. You cannot add new districts. You may increase the density. Okay. Obviously missed how you get spillover. Let's see. That's what happens when you read things in... One to three. Okay. And what happens if we get spillover? If you want to, I need to increase the density of a district that's already at max. The people's need for housing will persist and finds its expression in a new district of improvised and cheap housing. Okay. That makes sense. And we have a lot of citizens left. They're all being spurred to join by our newfound Blurtonium. So how many citizens do we have? We have quite a lot, and not a lot of districts. We have 13. So this could be interesting. So, some come and join the industry, the old industry, in Fitfort, however you want to say it. Two, three. Some come and join the new, slightly newer industry down here. Or 14. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4. Many come to the new industry. 5, 6, 7. Some move into the old places. 8. Actually, I think we have enough space. Some get rich. 9, 10, 11, 12. Some join the leader. 13, 14. Look at that, we're actually kind of perfect. The Free League have waned in popularity. No one really wants to join them. Name a feature as a final finishing touch. Each player gets to name one feature on the map, even one that wasn't put down yet. This could be a famous mountain, a road, a city gate, or a river. Okay. All right. We can name what we have here, I think. Oops, I've just realized you were not seeing what I was doing the whole time there. There we go. I put dots all over for the citizens. You were still looking at the document. I do apologize. There we go. So we already named Fit Fort. Let's see. I think this was the Blurt field, or the Blurt mine. You probably cannot read that appalling handwriting, but I don't think Procreate has a text tool. So these will be called they're the factories of Maga. I don't know why I'm going for such ominous sounding names, but anyway. I can't even read that. Maga Factory. Yeah, look at that great handwriting there. I'm sure you can all read that. This was the cave of... We never really found out what it was all about and who was involved, but it is the cave of Mysteria. There. This district was named after one of its founding fathers. It was the Movius. See what I did there. Oops, my camera has crashed. This has happened a couple of times recently. Bear with me. There we go. I'm not sure how long that went down for, having a few technical issues here, telling me it's time to wrap up maybe. But you're still seeing me drawing, so that's fine. And up here we need a name for this district. All right, I'm gonna go for even more original up here. The Goldie Hawks. There we go, that is the Duchy of Durham. We still have lots of empty space. Not quite sure what I did wrong there, but anyway, That was my playthrough of Ex Novo. Just to recap the game we have been playing, I'm probably pretty sure I got lots of things wrong. I generally do with games. I don't think it matters so much. You can see some wonderful examples of how you're actually supposed to do it. Probably much more useful with real people on a real map. You can see using tokens, factions, as opposed to me going backwards and forwards between iPad and various things. It is available on Itch. If you look up Shark Bomb, actually the link is at the bottom of the screen. I already had a brief chat with some of the creators, and they thanked me for the first stream, which actually was the most popular stream so far. So hopefully more of you come back to see how I did in the second half and how I ruined their lovely idea and the lovely city. That was me. Let's just have another quick recap of the Duchy of Duran. It's kind of ended up how I wanted, a dark place with mysterious creatures lurking that have not been quite discovered. It's very much like Carnival Row, actually. It's got dirty industry from a precious resource and a kind of remote leader that is bringing in imports of rich people and resources that they keep only for the select few. I think it's got a perfect setting for something. Not really sure what system or what game, but yeah. So that is me. That was the solo adventurer for another week. You can find out more at twitch.tv, The Solo Adventurer. You can also find me on YouTube at Christian Schiller. You can find christianschiller.com, of course. And yep, you can find most of my other contact details on that website. And I'll be back next week for another solo adventure.